fire. Some of you have lost your passion. You see the gears of life. The economy is going up and down. And so suddenly the economy goes up and down. So our relationship with God fluctuates. This minute we up and this minute we down. You see, sometimes we look at our paycheck and we look at it and we're like, oh God. Trust God. You might be seated. I'm going to trust God. Whether I have a job or whether I don't have a job. You see, the church becomes so lukewarm. We have lost our passion. We have lost our enthusiasm. And God is saying, I don't want a church that is lukewarm, but I'm looking for a church that is excited about my coming. My imminent return. But we're looking at the things that are happening around us and we don't get so terrified and horrified and all kind of fine. But you see, I'm confined in Jesus. Some of us need to wake up. We've been sleeping far too long. Oh, Shato. I feel the Holy Ghost tonight. Brother Sherry, I want to pray for you. I want you to come, brother. I want to pray for you tonight. I don't know what you're going through, but God is fixing you this time. I want to pray for you tonight. I haven't heard anything, but the Holy Ghost asked me to pray for you tonight. And God is saying to you tonight, I rebuke the devourer, the shadow. I curse the enemy. I command the blessing to come. The shadow. I rebuke the enemy. I rebuke the devourer. I command the witness of heaven. I command the blessings of God. I command the restoration. Jesus, be loose. I pray against every barrier. I pray against every hindrances. I pray against every tongue that comes against him. I command the blessings of God right now. In the name of Jesus, release him. Release him. Hey, shut up. Jesus, loose him right now. Hey, Chateau. Come on, Brother Sherman. You need to let go. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It's not by might. God said, you ain't gonna lose nothing. God said, I'm gonna restore you. I'm gonna give you everything that the conqueror has eaten. God said, I'm going to give you an increase. God said, I'm going to enlarge your borders. He said, I'm going to enlarge your territory. He said, I'm going to bless you till you don't have place to put it. Oh, shut up, oh, shut that. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. It is done. Signed, sealed, and delivered. Receive it in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Let's clap our hands and magnify the Lord. God is large and in charge. God is not real. We will go God in. You see, God, if there is not a democracy in God, God is not a democracy. God is a theocracy. You don't vote God in and you don't vote him out. God is still on the throne. tired of being sick and tired. I need God in my life. I need God to move on my behalf. I need God to move in my life. I'm tired of coming to church. I'm tired of being so churchified. I'm tired of going through the motions. I want God to move in my life. I want when I walk the streets that they call me blessing. I want when I walk in the church of the living God, my presence will see, we cannot live in God. We cannot take the living off of God. I don't know what your desires are. I don't know what really your relationship with God is. But God is saying, we become so lukewarm. We lost our fire and our passion. But God is saying, I'm getting ready. I need a church. I'm looking for the people that is on fire. I'm looking for a church that is excited about my coming. I'm looking for a church that is excited about who I am. We talk about everything else and we get excited about everything else. But when it comes to Jesus Christ, it's like pulling teeth. I tell myself, every time I get to do something for Jesus, I'm going to put all myself in it, I'm going to put all my energy in it, and I'm going to do it for God. The word lukewarm, it means to be half-hearted. I don't want to be half-hearted. I don't want to be a half-hearted Christian. I want to be in fire for Jesus. I said the church needs to be in fire.
Glory to God.
The church needs to be in fire. For God is a consuming fire. The Bible said when you receive the Holy Ghost, you're going to have some power.
Yes, yes.
We are not bastards. We are children. We are heirs of God. We are joint heirs with Him. We are not adopted children. We are not a foster kid. We are not foster children. But we belong to God. Don't be embarrassed. Look at yourself and see where you are with God. Don't be satisfied. There is so much more that God wants to do. I'm not satisfied. I know we talk about how great a service that we have. And how God moves. But that's what my mentality is. Service is not great unless somebody baptized in Jesus' name. Service is not great unless somebody received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You see, the mentality that we have, when we walk into the kingdom of God, when we walk into the house of God, we come in the house of God and we get our little blessing. And as soon as we walk outside the door, we forget who we are in God. But I want to walk in power. I want to be able to grip my blessing, to speak my blessing into existence. I don't want to sit there and ask somebody to come and bring God to me. But I want to walk in power and authority. I want to walk in the anointing of God so that I can give somebody something.
Yes.
Teach a man how to pour on corn. And he doesn't have to come at your door and knock. You see, God wants to empower us. God wants to empower us.